that time of year again. And when I say that, I don't mean holiday season. I mean it's that time of year when you are going to start editing your writing. Hip hip hooray. Yippee, one might say. Well, today's video is covering how to find and fix run-on sentences and fragment sentences in your writing. And this is an exact quote from Elf the movie. You're very welcome. I did not change it in the slightest. Okay, well, let's take a look at a few sentences that I wrote and how I would go about finding my errors and fixing them. Look at Remy. Oh, she is quite the nut. Anyway, okay, let's read the whole, this isn't a paragraph, I was going to say paragraph, segment in its entirety, and then I'll talk about how I would go about fixing it. Okay. Remy likes going on boat rides because she likes the wind in her fur. So we take her with us when we go out on the lake. Before we get in the boat, we make sure Remy is wearing her life jacket. She can swim, but she cannot keep afloat for very long. Okay, let's look at our first sentence. Remy likes going on boat rides. Is this a complete sentence? Well, does it have a capital letter? Does it end with punctuation? Yes. Does it have a subject? Well, yeah, we're talking about Remy. And does it have a predicate? Yes. What's Remy doing? Remy likes going on boat rides. So this is a complete, simple sentence. Hooray. Check mark. We did it. Okay, well, let's look at sentence number two. Because she likes the wind in her fur. Well, we know here we're starting with an awubbis word. An awubbis word is a trigger for us to know that we have begun a dependent clause. So we have to be sure that this dependent clause is attached to an independent clause, something that can stand on its own as a complete sentence. Well, we just have because she likes the wind in her fur. Okay, well, it's not attached to any independent clause. This actually can't stand on its own. It's just a dependent clause. How would I go about fixing that, you might ask? Well, I would actually combine my first two sentences. So because my first sentence was a simple sentence, I know I can combine it with this dependent clause. So this simple sentence now can support the dependent clause. I combine them together to create a complex sentence, one independent clause and one dependent clause. Remy likes going on boat rides because she likes the wind in her fur. Now this can stand on its own as a complete sentence. Now note, because I don't start with an awubbis word, I don't need a comma anywhere in here. My dependent clause comes at the end, so I don't need a comma. Okay, let's look at the next segment of this little paragraph. So we take her with us when we go out on the lake. Well, here I know I begin with a fanboy's word, and we haven't actually talked much about this in class, but you can't actually start a sentence with a fanboy's word. Why? Well, fanboy's words are used as connectors, as glue, as your trailer hitch between two independent clauses, two simple sentences. Well, I'm not connecting anything in this sentence, so I don't need a fanboy's word. In fact, to fix this, I can just delete the fanboy's word. It's not doing anything, it's not connecting anything, so it's unnecessary. Now I have a complete sentence. We take her with us when we go out on the lake. Perfect. Here's my next sentence. This is a long one, and that's a pretty good indication that it's a run-on sentence. Now, not all sentences that are long are run-on sentences, but you want to double check that any long sentence isn't a run-on sentence. So let's look at this one. Before we get in the boat, we make sure Remy is wearing her life jackets. She can swim, but she cannot keep afloat for very long. Well, let's look at this first part that I have up here. I start my sentence with an awubbis word, before. So I want to make sure that this dependent clause is attached to an independent clause. Well, my dependent clause is before we get in the boat. Well, I know I follow that up with we make sure Remy is wearing her life jacket, etc. So I know that I have this dependent clause supported. I added a comma here because I start with an awubbis word, before. So I have to, in this case, have a comma after that dependent clause. So I have, before we get in the boat, we make sure Remy is wearing her life jacket. She can swim, but she cannot keep afloat for very long. Here's my problem with this sentence. It's a run-on, and I know that because I'm trying to smush multiple ideas into one sentence. Now, for services of this piece of writing, we can't combine more than one idea in one sentence without really fancy punctuation like semicolons or colons, and we don't want to have to learn how to use those at this point. Those can get kind of tricky. So we have to decide what to do, how to separate these ideas without using fancy punctuation, which means we're going to have to create two sentences out of this one run-on sentence. So my first question is, what ideas am I trying to throw into this sentence? Well, I'm trying to say that we make sure Remy's wearing her life jacket, number one. And number two, I'm trying to say that Remy can't swim very long without her life jacket on. So here's my two ideas. We make sure Remy's wearing her life jacket, and she can't swim very long without her life jacket on. So I'm going to separate my two sentences around that general area. Before we get in the boat, comma, we make sure Remy is wearing her life jacket, period. She can swim, comma, but she cannot keep afloat for very long. See, in this last sentence here, she can swim, comma, but she can't keep afloat for very long, I have two independent clauses, and I've joined them with a comma and a fanboy. She can swim is a complete simple sentence. Subject, she, predicate, can swim. And I've combined or used my connector fanboy, comma, but, to combine my first independent clause, she can swim, with my second independent clause, she cannot keep afloat for very long. This is the successful use of a comma and a fanboy as a connector. So all in all, I've made multiple edits in order to make this section of a paragraph make sense and have correct and complete grammar and complete sentences. Here's the full thing. Remy likes going on boat rides because she likes the wind in her fur. We take her with us when we go out on the lake. Before we get in the boat, we make sure Remy is wearing her life jacket. She can swim, but she cannot keep afloat for very long. Here's what you learned in this video. If you start a sentence with an awapis word, you need to make sure your dependent clause is attached to an independent clause, aka a complete sentence. Otherwise, you have a fragment. You also learned that you can't start a sentence with a fanboy's word, like for, and, nor, but, or, yet, so. Usually, if you start a sentence with one of those little words, you can just delete them. You also learned that run-on sentences try to communicate more than one idea. So check to make sure that your ideas are separated between sentences so your reader knows where one idea starts and ends. Here you go. That's the joy of the season, right? Writer's workshop. Maybe Santa will hire you to start writing some ads for him or something.